Right, well, we're going to have the forecast in a moment, but it's Wednesday, which means it's On the Map Day. And Sara, you've been busy, haven't you, admiring some stained glass for this week's village.
I know, another real privilege. As Ian said, I'm feeling just the same, actually, because we went to Tewley this week in Kent near Tonbridge, and it was nominated by a few different people because there's some world-class art there, although not necessarily in the place you might expect it.
Like many tiny villages, a church lies at Tewley's heart. But it's not just worshippers and pilgrims who visit All Saints, it's art lovers too. For this is the only church in the world that has all of its windows decorated by the modernist artist Marc Chagall. These beautiful stained glass windows were born out of tragedy. When the daughter of a local family died in a boating accident, a window to commemorate her life was commissioned. Chagall needed to be persuaded, but eventually agreed to create the east window. But no one expected what happened next.
Chagall came to the installation of the window in the church, and he walked through the church, not having seen the glass installed before, and he walked through into the church and he said, "It's magnificent, I'll do them all." To which Chagall's host, Sir Henry Gavdubber Goldsmith, said, "Gee, I'm not a Rockefeller." The fear was that he was going to charge us to put the windows in, but the extraordinary man effectively charged us for the materials, but did not charge us for his expertise or craftsmanship.
The 12 windows tell biblical stories from Eden through to the resurrection. But in typical Chagall style, it's for the viewer to interpret some of the symbolism.
In the far corner over there, we have the story of Adam and Eve. And there's an apple, there's an angel swooping down with hand outstretched. And then we have the story of, effectively, of creation. We have, Chagall was famous for painting crescent moons, and he made them in glass as well. Round here, there's more yellow and gold and red coming in. Animals, goats and butterflies and bees. Chagall believed that blue was the colour of love. And I promise you, if you come here on a day when the sun is shining outside through that window, the entire floor is blue. You are surrounded by love.
And it's that sense of love that the vicar here wants visitors to experience.
Do come and visit in the sense of peace and quiet and contemplation, and just appreciate Chagall's wonderful legacy, which he has left, memorialising the sad death of Sarah, but making that a place of great encouragement and transformation.
Absolutely stunning. And one of my favourite things about On the Map is that word gets round the villages. And so that's why we know that tomorrow it's Postman Pete, who is the postman there, Peter Hogg. It's his 50th anniversary of being a postman. So tomorrow in Tewley, if you see him, definitely give him a bit of a wave, although hopefully he gets a bit of a lie-in in the morning. And I'm afraid if he is going to do the post round tomorrow morning, he's going to have to be prepared for some wet weather, maybe. Possibly. It's showers. Showers are difficult, aren't they, really? It's turning slowly cooler as well as those showers move in through the night tonight. And it's because we've got this area of low pressure just pushing our way at the moment. Bands of showers, hit and miss. We won't all see them, but definitely it's going to bring our temperatures down. The heat wave or microwave comes to an end tonight. Here are those showers then coming in. Could be heavy, could be thundery, but they zip through quite quickly by tomorrow morning. Mostly, I think we'll have lost the first band of showers. It'll be generally dry, but fairly murky and certainly muggy, with temperatures starting tomorrow in the mid-teens. As we go through the day, I think some of that cloud will lift, but then that could spark off further showers. It's pretty unsettled, but as I say, scattered. We won't all see them. And temperatures still a little above average for the time of year in the best of the sunshine at 23, maybe 24 degrees. It's Friday. Again, a lot of Mr. Murk around. Again, the risk of a shower. But if you look at your app and it looks pretty pessimistic, I'd say take that with a pinch of salt. Then there'll be an awful lot of dry weather around. At times the cloud will thin and break, but the temperatures, you can see they're starting to come back down. So as I say, it's pretty much all over in terms of that warmth. It may not be for a good few months until we see temperatures that high again. Here is that area of low pressure just pulling away, and then high pressure is building back in as we go through the weekend. Now, we know that that is our, as we call it, fair weather friend, but this one is fairly loose. It's not terribly exciting, and it means that there will be quite a bit of cloud mixed in with that. So, yeah, the symbols for the next couple of days not looking terribly edifying, but actually, we will have a lot of dry weather, I think, through the weekend. Yeah, I think there will be some breaks in the cloud here and there, and then confirmation in the long outlook that, yeah, there's no sign of that heat returning. I hope you really enjoyed it then, because it's not heading back our way. From tomorrow, temperatures a lot closer to where we'd expect for the time of year. For some people, it might be quite comfortable, and generally, it's often dry.
Thank you very much. I'm loving the Postman News, a brilliant new addition to the programme. Thanks, Sarah. That is it from us for now. We're going to leave you, though, with the scene this evening at Biggin Hill.
Dennis?
I've missed you.
Well, she ain't. None of us have.
Scarlett is my daughter. Whatever it takes. She is coming home with me.
Bring it on.
It's like I never left.
EastEnders. This week on BBC One and iPlayer.
Hiya, Kate with you on BBC One tonight, and we have the first Celebrity MasterChef semi-final here at 9. Now our Wednesday One guests include Jennifer Aniston and Reese Witherspoon, no less.